Hey guys, in my folder I have multiple .exe files. Each .exe file contains different data. Also, one of the .exe files has several worksheets. I intend to copy all worksheets from all .exe files into one workbook using Python. Therefore, I have created a blank Python file. First things first, I will import the required libraries. From pathlib, I will import path. Pathlib is a standard Python module, so no additional installation is required. Next, I will import xlwings as xw. If you do not have xlwings installed yet, you can install it by typing pip install xlwings in your command prompt or terminal. Once done, I will specify the source directory, which contains all the .exe files. In my case, the folder is called files and is located in the same directory as the Python script. If you just want to copy and paste this script, this is the only thing you would need to change. As a next step, I will store the .exe file paths from the given source directory in a Python list. Afterwards, I will create a new Excel workbook by using xw.book. I am using this new Excel workbook to combine all the data from the .exe files. This new workbook will look like this and has only one empty worksheet so far. To merge the data, I will iterate over each .exe file by using a for loop. Inside the for loop, I will first open up the .exe file. Then I'm using another for loop to iterate over each worksheet in the open workbook. By doing so, I can now copy the worksheet and paste it into our combined workbook. I will paste it right after the first worksheet. Afterwards, I can close the .exe file. Next, I will do some cleanup and delete the empty worksheet in our combined .exe file before saving it. For the file name, I will type allworksheets.xlsx. After I have saved the data, I will close the workbook. This part can be slightly tricky, because if we run our script and no previous .exe file was open, we are creating a new instance of .exe. Just by closing the workbook, we are not quitting the .exe instance. The .exe instance would be still available in our computer memory. However, I also want to avoid that we are just quitting the .exe instance, because in that case all other .exe files, which might be currently open on your computer, will be closed. Therefore, I will check how many workbooks are already open. If it's only one, so only our new combined workbook, I can quit the .exe instance. Otherwise, I will just close the workbook. Okay, and that's all there is to it. Let me save the script and head back to the command prompt to execute our Python file. Once done, we will have our new workbook, which contains all the worksheets from the other .exe files. However, every time you run the script, it will override the existing workbook. To prevent this, I will append the current date and time as a unique value to the worksheet's name. Back in the Python script, I will first import time. I will store the current local time in a variable called t. Next, I will format the time as follows. I can now take the timestamp and concatenate it with our .exe file name. Once done, I can rerun the script. Our new .exe file name will look like this one. Okay guys, and that's it for this tutorial. As always, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.